everybody, and welcome to En La Escena's Tiki Tiki Bochinche. And I am here with my special guest, Caridad de la Luz, La Bruja. Caridad, how are you?
I'm good. I everybody loves some good bochinche, so I'm really excited to bring the bimbosity.
Are you ready for this?
Yeah,
want to talk about stuff?
Yeah, let's get into it.
It's not too much. It's been a little bit of a slow week, but there's some stuff going on in New York, I'll tell you that much.
There's always something going on. Especially with Latinos. There's always something going on with us Latinos.
We'll make it up now, won't we?
Yes.
Just go down to Teresa's house or something, right?
Hasta bodeguero.
Exactly. So one thing I wanted to talk about is baseball controversy with Jorge Posada.
Have you heard about this? Don't tell me.
Yankees.
I love my Yankees.
Do you?
Yes, I do.
You know,
I'm boogie down Bronx all the way, and I love the Yankees, but what happened?
Can't relate. But
what happened?
So Jorge Posada was trying to get back into the lineup for the New York Yankees and found out that he was batting ninth in the lineup. When he heard that, he marched right over to Girardi and said, "I'm not going out there. I'm not playing if you're going to put me in ninth." And wound up basically quitting on the spot right there. So it's kind of like he went in and went,
he had a tantrum. Jorge Posada had a tantrum because he was in the wrong lineup. He wasn't like ranked up. And he's basically going to miss out on all the millions. And
that's the position that he put himself in. But I feel worse for the Yankee fans like yourself who have to witness somebody who has a reputation of being so professional being so unprofessional and kind of
Feel bad for his wife. All right, because she's probably like, "Jorge, what are you doing?"
She was trying to defend them, really. She tweeted and she said that he had a back condition, and then they had to refute it because, you know, you can't do that in baseball. But she was trying to defend her man. She's like, "I stand
by
my man."
Wait a minute. He's quitting the Yankees and he has a back condition.
Oh, she's in double trouble.
She's in double trouble. Poor woman. Ay, bendito, Mrs. Posada.
Bendito,
sí. Ay, Dios mío.
Yeah.
There's acupuncture for that.
You know, a lot of people are saying that he was batting at .165, which is not good at all. A lot of people are saying, you know, Jorge's about 39 years old now, might be waning out in baseball. He's had a couple of injuries and, again, that back problem going on. So I don't know what Yankee fans want to chime in and say, but you might be seeing less and less of Mr. Posada here.
Well, he better put the catcher's mitt up and catch something, all right? All right?
And bat something would be nice, too. But, you know, he gave a well-deserved apology today. I think he deserved to apologize. The fans deserve for him to apologize. Apologize to them for acting
he came
that
to
way.
His
That's
senses.
Just my opinion, though.
Okay,
he did come
all
to
right.
his senses.
All
so
right.
We can move on from
we
that
We can forgive
one.
You, Jorge. We hope you get better. Little heat pack, you know.
Good luck,
Crouching
Laura.
Tiger, hidden dragon.
We wish Laura good luck.
Yes, mamita.
And I feel bad. They're very nice people. I've met them, talked to them. They're wonderful people.
I know. We're only joking around.
But, you know. Then we move on to Alejandro Sanz. Did you hear what he did?
No. What did he do?
Alejandro Sanz, who has a 2 million person following on Twitter, decided that he was going to pull out of Twitter because somebody on Twitter accused him of spelling the word vuestra wrong. So he left Twitter and his 2 million followers. I mean, I was shocked. I have his notes here. He goes on to say, "Estoy harto de tanto ataque y tanta falacia, tanta mala baba y tanto esfuerzo para darle la vida a gente sin alma, sin cultura y sin corazón." I mean, this dude sounds
that was deep.
Upset.
That was deep.
Over.
I hope he spelled mala baba wrong because I never heard that word. Oh my God. You know what? Let me tell you, I'm a stickler for spelling. And spelling, you know, can make the difference between something romantic and something hideous. It could be, you know, when someone means, you know, dear sweetie and they put dear sweaty, that could end a relationship. So Alejandro, you know, please go back to the diccionario and, you know, study up and don't take it so personally.
I know. I think,
hey,
you know,
tiki tikis.
That sounds like.
Hold on 1 second, please.
Interruption.
By a J.I. star.
Dance. How do you spell tiki tiki?
97.9 La Mega, J.I. Star, El Boricua de New York contigo. It's just me and you to midnight. Y gracias por dejarme ser parte de tu noche. Here's Prince Royce. Stand by me. 97.9 La Mega.
You heard that?
Yeah, I heard that.
He said he was alone. What are we, chopped liver?
Back to you, tiki tiki.
Oh my goodness.
That's right.
Okay.
Where were we? Mala baba,
sweaty,
right?
Sweaty, sweetie. That's problems.
For Alejandro Sanz. I don't know. To me, it seems like a bad professional move. Don't you?
I think that could be.
2 million followers on Twitter. I mean, not that he's not going to get him back. I mean, he just got to jump back on Twitter. And it's probably going to help him to have a little bit of scandal.
Yeah,
you know, but not
true.
Over the word vuestra. He said he was writing nuestro something or nuestra something. So, I don't know. I just found that a little childish.
I think that maybe that's just an unresolved issue he had from childhood that maybe it brought up some emotions.
Yeah.
You know, like we all do that, you know, like it could have been, you know, some nun in Catholic school que le dio fuerte when he spelled something wrong. Y después, you know, ahí se enfogonó because it brought back memories. I'm sorry, Alejandro. It's going to be all right.
I think
it's
so.
It's going to be all right.
No pa tanto.
Sorry.
What else is going on? You watching any Latino television shows? Is any bochinche, anything that you have to
oh my god
to put out there? I mean,
sheesh. Oh, don't ask me about bochinche. I could only, you know, elaborate on bochinche and what I don't really like to talk much, but no, I don't know. Give me something to talk about. I really don't know about bochinche. I don't like to get myself in trouble too much, but you know.
Not too much.
Not too
just
much.
Just a little bit.
Not too much. I heard that, you know, there was nail drying, the 1 minute nail drying, the nail polish has now gone to 30 seconds. So ladies, be pendiente. That's revolutionary, you know, because you don't want to be waiting too long for your nails to dry. So I don't know. That's not bochinche. That's just a tip.
Now we're doing tiki tiki tips. Plus
tiki tiki tips.
All right. Well, like I said, it was a slow
week.
That
was it.
That's it for
today. No. Okay, let's make something up.
What do you want to make up about who? Let's pick a target first.
I heard that Derek Jeter,
who is not Latino,
he's Puerto Rican. It turns out that yes, you know who else is Puerto Rican?
Who else?
Obama. That's right.
That
Obama is Puerto Rican.
The first Latino in office.
That's right. On the low.
That's nice.
I have the original birth certificate. And he's Boricua.
That's great. Well, you know, all these stars are trying to sing and everything. Wilmer Valderrama is now coming
he's
out.
He's singing
with something.
Too?
Yeah.
Oh my God. He went from your mama jokes to singing.
No,
oh my
I
God.
I heard it's a complete comedic spoof and he's just doing some silly stuff. But I had mentioned last week on Tiki Tiki that Salma Hayek is also coming out with some music. So
really?
It's just funny how, you know, it's all parlaying.
But, you know, I think that Latinos were like that. You know, we get bored very easily.
Yes, we do.
So we like to venture out and do other things. So that's not surprising.
Miss multi-talented.
You know, that's really what it is. That's why I do all these things, because I get bored.
Yeah.
I can't just do
hey,
one thing.
Well, if you can
you know?
Do everything, then why not, right?
True.
You have that potential. What you want to make something else up? Or are you good for right now?
You know, John Leguizamo's not Puerto Rican, but he's in the Puerto Rican Day Parade.
There's a lot of people in the
he's
Puerto Rican Day Parade who are not.
That's not what I heard.
Oh, wow.
But we love you. But I'm just saying, I was like, is he? I thought he was Colombian.
I think he's half. No, isn't he half?
He's not
half. Puerto Rican?
He was half and half.
Cuban. Oh, Colombian?
Yeah.
Yeah,
I don't
he
know. I'm gonna go see you at your show, Ghetto Clown, John Leguizamo. And you know what?
You.
It was hot.
It was hot.
It was hot. I know
really
he's
good.
So talented, but I'm gonna. You know what? I'm gonna go with a DNA test.
Yeah,
I'm gonna give John Leguizamo a DNA test, and I'm gonna figure out where you're really from. Cause what kind of name is Leguizamo? Come on, that's
ooh,
like.
Ooh, Leguizamo. That's a good point there.
Right?
Are you going to grab up one of his hairs? I don't know how you're going to go about that.
And do the DNA
I'm
going to
give
testing.
Him a cheek swab.
Okay, I'm not touching that one. I'm not touching that at all.
If you'll let me, I'll be like, here's a lollipop.
Ah. Shout out to Ruperto Vanderpool, who's
going
to be doing a show with me. It's a spoken word. He'll be doing comedy. I'll be doing spoken word on May 25th at Hudson River Cafe at 8 o'clock. Hopefully
I hope
you can
to be
make
there.
It. That would
you
be
know
wonderful.
That he was in my video. I have the Piragüero video. If you go on YouTube and go look up Piragüero, La Bruja,
Piragüero.
Ruperto Vanderpool, he's my Piragüero in the
shout
video. And
you,
it's
Ruperto.
Really, really cool.
I'm going to have to bring him up for Tiki Tiki one day.
Oh, he's a Tiki Tikier.
Yeah, I know.
Super Tiki.
You see him doing this.
He's the only guy I have ever danced a merengue with, and he went through my legs. That is a true story. I've never seen it. He's so talented. I was like, I've never seen a man do this. And I'm not that tall. I was like, whoa. God bless
I'm
going
to leave that alone, too. Wow.
I'm just, and that's
she's
not even
impressed,
bochinche.
Ruperto.
Yeah, I'm flattered.
Anyway, enough love match on Tiki Tiki. All right, everybody. That's it for today. We had a great time, Caridad. Thank you so much for joining
awesome.
Me. This was so much fun.
Yes.
Don't forget to check us out, enlaescena.com. You want to plug yours, too?
What? I don't know. You already know. LaBrujaMusic.com. You already know. Find me. Look for me. You know?
Everybody knows La Bruja.
Googleame. Por favor.
Everybody knows this woman. Make sure you come back next week because we have more Tiki Tiki. I'm Leticia with Caridad. You're watching Enlaescena.